Everybody, I'm Lana Humble, and today I'm going to be performing a musical theatre set for you from my home to yours, starting off with Waitress, This Is When He Sees Me.
I stick with real things, usually facts and figures. When information's in its place, I minimise the guessing game. Guess what? I don't like guessing games. Oh, when I feel things before I know the feelings, how am I supposed to operate if I'm just tossed around by fate? Like on an unexpected date with a stranger who might talk too fast or ask me questions about myself before I've decided that he can ask me questions about myself. He might sit too close or call the waiter by his first name, or eat Oreos, but eat the cookie before the cream. But what scares me the most is, what if when he sees me, what if he doesn't like it, what if he runs the other way and I can't hide from it? Disappointed. What if I give myself away to only get it given back? I couldn't live with that. So I'm just fine inside my shell-shaped mind. This way I get the best view, so that when he sees me, I want him to.
Dawn, don't you think you're being a little loving? Maybe just a tad.
I'm not defensive. I'm simply being cautious. I can't risk reckless dating due to my miscalculating. While a certain suitor stands in line, I've seen in movies, most made for television, you cannot be too careful when it comes to sharing your life. I could end up a miserable wife. I'm sorry, girls, but he could be criminal. Some sort of psychopath who escaped from an institution somewhere where they don't have girls. He could have masterminded some way to find me. He could be colorblind. How untrustworthy is that? He could be less than kind, or even worse, he could be very nice, have lovely eyes, and make me laugh, come out of hiding. What do I do with that? Oh God, what if when he sees me, I like him and he knows it. What if he opens up a door and I can close it? What happens then? If when he holds me, my heart is set in motion, I'm not prepared for that. Someone who, when he sees me, wants to again.
Has anybody watching heard of the musical Nine? Because Nine is a musical that I discovered quite a while ago now when my singing teacher asked me to perform a song from it called Unusual Way. Now this piece is so hauntingly beautiful that I couldn't not perform it here for you today and make you feel the same way that I did when I first heard it.
In a very unusual way, one time I needed you. In a very unusual way, you were my friend. Maybe it lasted a day, maybe it lasted an hour, somehow it will never. inside me goes weak. Something inside me surrenders, and you're the reason why. You're the reason why. You don't know what you do to me. You don't have a clue. You can't tell what it's like to be me. It appears I won't stay, I never go. Special to me in my life, since the first day that I met you. How could I ever forget you once you had touched my soul?
Musical is about Henry VIII's six ex-wives and shows them forming a band and comparing which queen had it the worst with Henry. I first heard about it through YouTube and it just had a brilliant first impression with me that made me feel like a queen yet vulnerable at the same time. So I hope this brings out your inner queens and kings. I'll agree I'm the 10 amongst these threes. Ever since I was a child, I make the boys go wild. Take my first music teacher, Henry Mannix. I was young, it's true, but even then I knew the only thing you wanna do is broad, dark, sexy. Mannix taught me all about dynamics. He was 23 and I was 13, going on 30. We spent hours strumming the lute, striking the chords and blowing the flute. He plucked my strings all the way to G, went from major to minor, C to D. Tell me what you need, what you want. You don't need to plead, 'cause I feel the chemistry. Like I get you and you get me, and maybe this is it. He just cares so much, it feels legit. We have a connection. I think this guy is different. 'Cause is touch me, love me, can't get enough. See, squeeze me, birds and the bees me. Run your fingers through my hair. Tell me I'm the fairest of the fair. Playtime's over. The only thing you wanna do is... Yeah, that didn't work out. So I decided to have a break from boys. And you never guess who I met. Tall, large, Henry VIII, supreme head of the Church of England. Globally revered, although you wouldn't know it from the look of their beard. Made me a lady in waiting, held me and my family up in the world. Gave me duties in court, and he swears it's true that without me he doesn't know what he'd do. You see, I'm all you need, all you want, we both agree. This is calls me love. He says we have a connection.
I guess it's not so different. 'Cause do they is touch me, love me, can't get enough. Birds and the bees, me. There's no time for when or how, 'cause you just got to have me now.
Playtime's over. Only thing you wanna do is. So we got married. Woo! With Henry, it isn't easy. His temper's short and his mates are sleazy. Except for this one courtier, he's a really nice guy, just so sincere.
The royal life isn't what I planned, but Thomas is there to lend a helping hand. So sweet, make sure that I'm okay, and we hang out loads when the king's away. This guy finally is what I want, the friend I need. Just mates, no chemistry. And there's nothing more to it. He just cares so much, he's devoted. He says we have a connection. I thought this time was different. Why did I think he'd be different? But it's never, ever different. If you don't please me, bite my lip and pull my hair as you tell me I'm the fairest of the fair. Playtime's over. Playtime's over. Playtime's over. The only thing you wanna do is.
I hope you enjoyed my musical theatre set today, and if you did, please remember to follow my social medias, Instagram at lanahumblemusic and YouTube lanahumble. And thank you very much for watching. Bye!